Hello, everybody, and thanks for joining me again for another one of the Our New Normal sessions. It's part of a T.O.F.U Talks limited series that I'm doing to try and give people a glimpse into the COVID-19 pandemic experience from around the world. I've been talking to a lot of vegans that I know and some people that I've actually never even been able to meet, but I've communicated with online. And I've also been able to catch up with some close friends and people that I've known for a long time now. In fact, today I'm lucky enough to be able to interview someone who I've probably known the longest. And I'm happy to hear from them. And I'm hoping that what they bring to the table for their part of the world will maybe be something you connect with or learn from. So on that note, could you please introduce yourself? Sure. I think we do have a lot in common, like you said. My name is Ryan Patey, and I'm the publisher of T.O.F.U magazine and a full-time traveler. Yeah, no, I think we do have a lot in common, and I definitely agree with you on that. So where are you now? I'm in Saigon, Vietnam. I've been here off and on for about 3 years now. Okay. And so since you've been there for a bit, what sort of measures are in place in your area, and do you feel that people are complying with the stuff that's being, you know, put out there by the government? Compliance kind of depends on who you talk to. And as for the measures, there's been stuff in place since about January. It's been kind of a long-term sort of bunch of changes, but the numbers have been really good. And so hopefully things will continue that way. But I mean, yeah, masks are mandatory, lots of travel restrictions.
So it sounds like, yeah, stuff has been happening there for a while now. But I'm happy to hear that things seem to be going relatively well. On that note, how have the measures impacted you? You know, obviously, you've had to deal with some changes. So how have you been coping with this? What is your secret to keeping yourself sort of positive and motivated during this pandemic?
To be honest, things have been pretty good. Because of the low number of cases, I'm not too afraid. otherwise, I've just kind of been trying to be productive, talking with a lot of friends and family, and trying to keep things going with the magazine. That's about it.
Okay. I'm glad to hear that things are going relatively well, and I hope that continues. So looking forward to kind of, you know, when this all ends, which obviously it's going to happen in different ways in different countries and everything. Maybe hopefully Vietnam is kind of closer to that than you know, some other places that I know of. But when this does end, when we kind of get the green light to go out into the world and act, you know, normal, what do you think you're going to take from this experience? What do you think you've learned, and what do you hope that the world learns, or how do you hope things change after this tragedy is kind of just a part of history? I think for me, I'm going to try and talk more with friends and family. Being socially isolated has kind of pushed that importance for me, and I really hope that the world kind of learns to appreciate, you know, frontline workers and so many other people a lot more compassion, basically.
Yeah, not surprisingly, I agree with you. I think because, you know, I feel like we're on the same page in a lot of ways. And hopefully that's true. Hopefully that, you know, stuff like that will happen. And hopefully, and I'm glad to hear that, you know, that you're going to maybe take something from this positive. For now, I guess I just want to say thanks for sharing your part of the world with everybody, and I hope that people get something out of it. Maybe sometime when we're able to go to cafes and stuff, we'll cross paths. We can grab a drink and chat more. For now, though, I guess I could maybe offer you this. Yeah, if you want to?
Yeah, okay. Sure.
Thanks.
Yeah, it's the least I can do. You're so kind to join me for this interview.
It was my pleasure.
I hope the rest of your day goes well. And I guess, yeah, to everybody else, I'll see you for the next episode.
Bye.